Stocks falling to session lows then, with the Dow headed for a seventh down day, now down 3% for the year. The S&P 500 is retesting its 200-day moving average. Now, what's important to point out here is that we've done this twice this summer. On both occasions, you see the way in which the market rips higher because people buy the dip. Jim Cramer said, though, that investors are now reluctant to buy the dips. So can you find value in this market? Do you buy here? On the right of your screen, Andrew Slimmon, Senior Portfolio Manager at Morgan Stanley Wealth Management. And here's Ken Kamen, President of Mercadien Asset Management. Do you buy the dips?
Yeah, I would. I think the biggest fear now in the market is the Fed, that they're not going to raise rates.
And sorry, the biggest fear is that the Fed won't raise rates.
That way they won't raise rates, meaning that they're going to delay to December and prolong this pain that we have. We just need to get a Fed move behind us, and I think it's going to be, I won't say all clear after they do that, but people are going to be happy that they're buying into the down now. In the old adage, it was buy on the rumor, sell on the news.
Right.
Now it's the exact opposite. You actually want to be buying on the news, because now we're getting the rumor crushing the stock market.
That would sound to me very dangerous, a dangerous thing to say to people when they start raising rates, buy stocks. What do I know?
Economy's strong. It's telling people the economy is strengthening. Historically, the market does well after the first Fed rate increase. And so I think that's what's going to happen. We're getting this news behind us. It's only 25 basis points, and then the market will rally.
Central Bank has never waited this long. What are we, 6 or 7 years now into emergency funding? They've never waited this long to act.
Correct. But
so a lot of your usual old wives' tales,
sure,
that have no doubt always worked in the past, right, will not work potentially this time, because this time's really different.
Right. Maybe, maybe not. But maybe it's just because the economy has been in such a slow growth environment for a lot longer than normal. That's why they've waited this long. Also, I think really the news of the Fed rate increase has been so well telegraphed that we just got to get behind this. And what's happening this month is just the losers are rallying and the winners are selling off. It's a classic August.
What do you think is going to work best to year end or for the next year?
Well, I actually think you start looking at maybe financials again if we start getting a little bit of, you know, interest rate ability, you know, for them to make some money.
Do you think that's likely? Do you think they're going to have enough from the Federal Reserve to trigger that? Because financials have really not done what many of us hoped they would do. Big part of the market.
I agree. Probably not to be real jet fuel for the market, but if you're looking for places to go in a market that's been kind of range-bound, that's not a bad place to go. I still think you need to look overseas. Europe has got that printing press going, so we're going to start seeing the effects that we've lived through for the last few years over there.
I love the fact you start the conversation by saying, you should buy stocks when they raise rates, and then say, actually, go where they're not raising rates.
Well, because they're printing money.
Well, but in a slow growth environment, they may raise rates, even though the economy is still in a slow growth environment. Growth stocks probably will continue to do well, not value stocks.
So what do you think here?
That as much as it's hard to believe, I still think there's a lot of healthcare opportunity. Healthcare stocks are selling off because it's a classic August. You should set up to look to buy some of those going into September. Could be a very good opportunity because September is a month when the winners regain their momentum. And that's been healthcare year to date. So this is a great opportunity to figure out which companies met their numbers, beat their numbers, doing well, reasonably priced, and they sold off because it's August. Line those up and get ready to buy them going into September. Great buying opportunity.
Quick question for you both, and I should know the answer from what you've said. Will the market be higher or lower by the end of the year?
I think it'll be higher from where it is right now by the
higher
end of the year.
Substantially higher?
Higher.
Appreciably higher.
Appreciably
higher. The only question is, is it will it be a fall rally or a Santa Claus rally? That's the question.
Don't start me on the Santa Claus rally. Nice to see you both. Have a good weekend.
Thank you.
Andrew Slimmon there and Ken Kamen.